What's up, guys? Chris here from TM32 and Fedora Gaming. Welcome to another episode of our Fire Emblem Fates Conquest playthrough. In this episode, I think we already went through our support conversations in the last episode. In this episode, we're just going to go straight into the next battle. I don't think there's anything else we need to do. In a previous episode, before the last one, we had done a lot of my castle stuff, interacting with other people's castles. We got some more inventory items based on castle bonuses, I think. Where is it? Rewards. So someone asked me in a previous episode in the comments where I got all these weird items that I've been picking up off screen. And I've been doing that mostly through interacting with my castle and having other people come to my castle as well. So we get battle bonuses if you do castle battles, or if people battle with you in your castle. And also if people visit your castle and things like that. So the more people that come in and visit your castle, or the more visits you do to other people's castles, you get more points, which will unlock new items here. So recently, I think I got these dual weapons, a dual katana and a dual naginata, which invert the weapon triangle, which is kind of cool. Haven't really experimented with that yet, but we might be able to do that in our next battle here. So that's where all these weird things are coming from. If you guys ever ask yourself, like, hey, he has a weapon that this character has a weapon that they didn't have before, and it was never shown on video, that's probably where it happened. Invasion 1, level 10 enemies. Let's see where this goes. Doesn't seem like there's going to be a whole lot in the way of story for this. And there's none! There's absolutely none! Okay. So this is, I'm assuming this is supposed to be a simulation of one of the player versus player castle battles. And looks exactly like it probably would. So each of my units are stationed at a building of mine, which is actually kind of problematic because my buildings are super spaced out. So, oh God, who is it that has a killing edge? I saw this guy. Oh no. No, 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 no. I don't like that. I don't like that. So let's take a look at these guys. So first of all, we have how many? No, don't start the battle yet. Oh my God. I'm trying to press the map button. We have 11 enemies on the field. So this guy, we have one with a killing edge. These guys are pretty okay with javelin, so he can attack from range. Steel lance. These guys are gonna hurt. These guys are gonna hurt a lot. The elbow room there. Wyvern riders, we haven't encountered any of those guys yet. But they can hit. I'm not organized enough for this, I don't think. Iron axe, steel axe. I mean, they have a couple of pair-ups as well. So I think what we're gonna have to do. Oh, this is gonna be rough. I think we're gonna need to have Effie in one place. Oh, we also have our bond units. I'm not sure if we want to use those guys. Flint and her sister Mint, who is another bond unit that we just birthed not that long ago, a troubadour. She looks like she has icy blood, which I think is Flora's personal ability. She has resistance plus 2, she has renewal, restores up to 30% HP at the start of each turn, which is phenomenal. And then Dragon Fang. Who are we missing though? I think we're missing Mozu. Maybe we should keep missing Mozu. I'm not sure she's gonna stand up to any of these guys, especially with how spread out we are. Like, I wonder if we should just try to make a break for her, because they're all gonna try and come up here. Because their goal is to basically seize the throne, and we have to defend it. Oh, and we have Lilith here as well. Astral Breath. 26 attack. Can she die? I think she can die, can't she? Can she? I don't know. So these guys aren't gonna do a whole lot. They have a couple of iron axes, steel axe. Actually, I take that back. They have a fair amount of strength. 27 attack. This is actually really bad, you guys. I'm not sure if I'm gonna be prepared for this. Especially with everyone being as spread out as they are. I feel like I'm gonna just have everyone die horribly. And we don't have any advantages to my knowledge in terms of, like, some of the higher level castles, you can get statues that, like, increase damage or, like, cause everyone on, like, who's invading your castle to take, like, 20% of their max HP and damage every turn. We don't have any of that. So, but at the same time, we do have these bonuses here, because each of our buildings do provide bonuses. Damage taken minus 3. I forgot about that. Damage inflicted plus 3. Is it all... Yeah, damage inflicted plus 3. I'm looking in the wrong place for these. This one doesn't do anything, that one doesn't do anything, that one doesn't do anything, that one doesn't do anything. Crit plus 5, dodge plus 10, so we might be able to survive. This makes me super nervous, though. Because like I said, I'm not really in a position to be able to take advantage of this. Axes, actually this would be a bad place for Effie. They all have axes, which would beat lances. However, like I was mentioning before, we could have... Where is it? The dual Naginata. Oh, it's rank C. She can't even use it yet. She can't even use it yet. Okay, so yeah, that'd be a bad idea. So I think we need to swap Effie and Silas? No. Effie goes down here. Effie goes down here. 17, so she wouldn't take a whole lot of damage there. Underdog, hit avoid plus 15 if a foe's level is higher. Okay. We're probably gonna end up losing our bond units here. So we need to figure out pair-ups now. Or no, we need to figure out who's going to go over here with the lances. We would need to have an axe user, but at the same time... Like, having... I don't like the idea of having Arthur over here by himself without someone like Effie to be able to support. It seems like Niles would make more sense going up here. How can we get him over here without getting him killed? I might have to rearrange my castle after this match, after this battle, because this is not very effective, a very effective way to defend. It could be that maybe we just have everyone fall back to the stairs, have a little bit of an evasion boost, it looks like, and let everyone come to me, but at the same time... I don't know, Effie could probably hold her own against these chumps. But what do they have here? We already had the underdog, this guy has... Strong riposte. Unit deals plus 3 damage when counterattacking. Oh, this guy has a fair bit of stuff, a silver sword. That's not good. Silver sword, he has lunge. After attacking, switch positions with target. Armored blow. Unit receives minus 10 physical damage when the unit initiates an attack. Wow. And good fortune restores up to 20% HP at the start of each turn. So, wow. Wow, this is... I feel like this is a bad idea, you guys. I feel like this is a super bad idea. We have damage taken minus 3. I guess that would help, I guess. We can add plus 3 defense and resistance to everyone here. How does Arthur have 15 defense? Status plus 4, so he must have gotten like a surge last time I talked to him. And he gets plus 2 defense from his Justice Axe, which is nice. So maybe he could survive. 22, 18, 22. He's going to take actually 25. So he's going to take 10 damage from this guy. 3 damage. No, he's going to take no damage from that guy. Eh, he can work. He can potentially work. I feel like we can probably... I'm struggling to figure out exactly how this is going to work. I think what we're going to do is we're going to pair up Felicia with myself. Maybe I should pair up the healers with somebody that could do damage. Because these guys have a fair bit of defense, not a whole lot of resistance. These guys could go either way. I don't want to take a crit from him, but he's not going to do any damage to me. So, I'm not too worried. Who am I missing? I'm missing either Mint or Mozu. I feel like we could use more healing. I don't think I have any healing staves. I don't think I have any more healing staves for Mint. I do. I have one. Alright, we'll stick with... No, maybe I want to use Mozu, though. I want to use Mozu. Get rid of her. Mozu's going to get herself killed, but I want to see if I can use her properly. At the very least, she can be a dual guard for someone else. That might be how we do it. 17... So Silas will be able to take somewhat of a beating here. I think we can move him up to a place where Elise will be able to... He'll be able to draw their attention, draw their fire. But a place where Elise will also be able to help. I think that'll be good. So these two will be fine right here. Probably do the same thing with Arthur and Felicia. But at the same time, I feel like we could probably pair up someone. What would happen if we paired up Mozu with Arthur? He gets skill and luck by the looks of it. I feel like we should do that. And we can have Felicia nearby to help out that way. We can have Odin and Effie together. Niles will be able to help out with whatever Niles can help out with. I wonder if we should switch these two. Nah. We'll let Niles. He's pretty high level. We can let him go on that for now. No resistance on Flint. What does he have? He has bow breaker. have damage when adjacent ally is attacked. Maybe we should have him nearby with these two. That's actually not a bad idea. Let's have Flint and Felicia pair up. What's the chance of that happening? Target's luck stat times 05. So that's not going to be actually a very good chance. If the target is Arthur, not going to be good. So we'll switch. We'll leave him with Felicia. Yeah, I think this will work. Effie can stay there. She can move into one of these two places to lure them out. This might actually be the better place. Step down here, have Odin come right behind her. Make sure he switches to Grimdark Bolt when we can. I guess we can give it a try. I'm getting a bad feeling about this, but I'm getting a very bad feeling about this. Let me double check my inventory before we go. Make sure everything has what they need. Got a heal spell, Bloom Festal, heal and freeze. Yep. Oh, Flint could use a weapon. Just in case. Probably not going to do a whole lot in the way of actual combat, but just in case. Just in case we need him to do something. Mozu has the Naginata. Can we get her anything else that might be helpful? Bronze Lance is exactly the same. Yeah, it looks like she's okay there. Okay, here we go. Defend the throne and rout the enemy. I should have switched my own spot, to be honest. I probably should have had someone worthless sit up here because they're not going to get anywhere near me, and I could have been a very helpful contender. I like this music. It's very chill music. It's almost inappropriately chill music for the fact that my castle is being invaded. And Lilith is here. She can't move, but she can do damage if I put her... if I actually draw their attention up there. The question is, will I be able to? How many people can attack? This is the only person that can attack the first turn if we move Effie over. Steel sword with the underdog. What's that? Oh, that's kind of cool. So people with, I'm assuming, killing edge weapons or weapons that the person should be aware of, that the unit should be aware of, are highlighted. I didn't realize that was the thing. That was certainly wasn't a thing in Fire Emblem Awakening because I died way too many times by putting my knight in front of an enemy with a hammer, something like that. So let's figure out where Effie can go. Put her right here. With her Lily's Poise of Awesomeness. These guys are all using axes, so we need to switch to a sword. Put Silas right here, switch to Iron Sword. Or the Katana. But I think the Katana had... yeah, it reduced our defense and resistance. So let's do that. That should be good. So there's elbow room and shelter, so he'll be doing more damage because he's sitting on a plane space. Again, he'll only have to handle one invader at the start. We can't move Odin all the way over to this spot. I would like to be able to potentially move back if we can, and like try and position ourselves so that Lilith can get some action. But let's try this. This way they'll come in through up here, and then hopefully we can back up without trapping Odin. Yeah, this should be okay. This should be okay. She's not going to take any damage. She has 17 defense minus the 3, I think, from the records hall. This should be okay. And then for these guys... These guys shouldn't be too much of a worry, to be honest. Oh, but this guy can... Wow, they do no damage at all. Do any of them do damage? 6 from that guy. It's a good thing we gave him a forged axe. Forged axe of justice. I think I want to put myself in a position where we can get hit by one of these two guys. I mean, this guy's going to try and pair up with me, or he's going to pair up against me. I want to try and actually put myself in a position where I don't just get hit by that guy by himself and just end up drawing them out, because I'm going to need some help, I think. I don't know if they're just going to go straight for a beeline up to the throne, because if so, I might have problems. So he can go up to this spot right here. And so can he. I think we do that. We just sit right here. Sit right here. So take less damage now because of Valicia's Demoiselle. The only person I have left, I have Niles, who can come right over here. Break. Oh, I can do damage to my own buildings. Don't think I need to do that. I also don't really want to get Niles caught by himself, but he seems to be okay for the time being. So unless this guy starts hunting me down, in which case I'll have problems. Oh god, I'm gonna have problems. No, it should be fine. It should be fine. And then myself, I guess I'll just sit here and look pretty. See how it works. You're gonna destroy my building? Screw you! What a jerk thing to do. What a totally jerk thing to do. They're not even trying to go for me. The darkness whispers. Fine. No hands. That kind of throws off my plan. They're not even attacking me. What the hell? What's going on? I'm going to panic now though, because Niles is kind of in a bad spot. I'm gonna need to do this. Can I get over there in time, though? No, he can't make it. I mean, I probably could murder these guys. I could murder the one. I could kill this one, and then shelter Niles, and then make sure I stay out of harm's way of this guy. Yeah, I think we do that. I want to make sure I can do this, though. Yeah. I don't really want to leave Niles out in harm's way. Just want to make sure. Use to pull another player unit into cover. Okay. So we're going to do this. Oh my god, Niles! Oh my god. Niles is... I don't know how Nintendo was okay with putting so many sexually suggestive things for Niles into one condensed character. Like, he is the walking sexual innuendo. But I love him. He's great. Okay, so we're now going to... Yeah, we're gonna have to shelter Niles. Yoink. Move Elise not right into the line of fire, but right next to it. I don't know if this guy's gonna go down. I have no idea if this guy's gonna go try and get rid of my accessory shop. Oh, I know what they're doing! They're destroying the plots that give benefits. Oh, that sucks. They're destroying the places that give benefits. So I don't have that... I'm not gonna have that damage taken minus 3 anymore. I'm not gonna have that hit plus 5, damage increased plus 3 situation anymore. Crap. I didn't realize that. That sucks. Now I have to back way the hell up. Oh God. I can break the statue? Oh yeah, because the statues provide benefits as well. I forgot about that. You gonna go for me now? Uh-oh. Oh, right. The javelin dude can hit Felicia now. I think I should probably bring myself into the mix at this point. As dangerous as it seems for me to be, if they can make their way onto the throne room, onto the throne panel in time for me to, before I can actually make my way over there myself, that could be kind of problematic. Oh boy, let's get some experience for Odin. Haha! Still not leveling up, though. I think we just start making our way back to the front, back to the throne. So it seems like we're gonna have to converge on that point anyway. Who else? I'm the only person that can move. I feel like I'm gonna need to be able to assist these guys. So let's go... Let's go over here. Yeah, I don't care about that one so much. Crit plus 5. Whatever.
We won't give up.
Good whiff. And he will have his stats reduced. Felicia gets a level.
Yes.
A pretty good level. No strength, though. That could have been useful. That's okay. Wow, even... Oh, God. This could be a problem. Oh, yep. See, right there. Right there. They can get to the throne now. And I can't! Oh, crap! I seriously just screwed myself like that? Did I seriously just do that? How could I not go back there? I just came from there. How can I not go back there? Can I not step onto the throne thingy again if I step off of it? Cause if so, that's kind of ridiculous. And did this guy just get some of his health back? Is that what happened? I did five times two, so that works. Oh, that sucks! That'll take care of this one, because he can get to the throne, and so- No, he can't, actually. He can't. He'll get close. Neither one of them can actually get there. Let's do this. That'll weaken him. We can bring Arthur and Mozu up here. 80% shot. Gotta do it.
Here I go.
Thank you, Arthur, for not missing. Yeah, seriously, Odin and Arthur need to hang out and work on their laughs. Such power, so just, much wow. That was a really good level, though. HP, strength, skill, speed. He even got a point in luck. My goodness. He's more lucky now. He's not the most unlucky person on the team, I don't think. Well, he probably still is, but... Who can hit Felicia? Oh, the javelin. Javelin man. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I can't actually step on the throne after I leave it. That sucks. I wish I had known that before I had done anything in that regard. Can I move her? Okay, yeah. I can move them both. Can't kill him. I think I have to finish them off. I have to finish this guy. No! No, 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 I can't do that! I can't do that. What I would have to do- well, I- I can finish him off, but I have to heal. I have to heal Elise first. I think I just screwed myself by moving off of that panel. Moving off of the throne panel. I'll have to, like, build a wall right here to prevent them from getting at me, but the problem is that'll leave Felicia open. Maybe we'll have to switch over to Flint. Maybe Flint will have to do some work. Our bond unit, our non-existent person that doesn't have any story value whatsoever. How will I fare against this guy? 22... attack. He has plus 2 strength. 22 attack. I have 15 defense. I'm going to take a couple of hits. But I'll be able to dish it out, too. A little bit. A little bit. None of these other guys can come at me, right? Oh, this guy can. This guy could actually double up. If he wanted to. If I go into that corner space. If I go right here, he'd be able to actually hit me as well. So let's move here. Yeah, so... I'm really gonna have to reorganize my castle if I'm gonna keep doing these invasions. Let's pair these two up. Move them slowly forward. We'll leave these guys alone for a while. Actually, maybe we shouldn't have done that. Maybe we should have just pursued them, because they're gonna, after they get rid of the accessory shop, they're gonna come straight for us. Might as well just have let them go after Effie and Odin. Maybe we'll do that. Maybe we'll just move them off to the right over here after this next turn. I don't know. We'll see what happens. Let's heal. Actually, let's make sure. Oh, crap. He would actually still be in my line of sight. I would be in his line of sight unless I move here. Heal. Still laughing at Niles. Okay.
All right, come on.
That guy is wearing no clothes. Oh, because I hit him with the Raider's katana. I stripped the spirit of its clothing.
We made it.
Oh crap! 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 I forgot he had a dual guard. Did I just get at least killed? Please don't tell me I got at least killed. She can take it, right? Right? Right?
We have no choice.
She can take it. And he missed anyway. Whew! Okay. We can get this next part. We can get this next part. So, Felicia can go kill this guy, no problem. I can come in, kill one of these two. Can kill neither of these two. But that's a problem, because now any of them can come at the throne. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. If I block them here, if I put two people here and kill this guy, he won't be able to go after the throne. This one right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. He'll be one spot away if I have a blockade right here. The problem is that I'm gonna need some healing. I'm gonna need some healing, and if I let them go, because this guy's going to be on a floor space. Well, he's not going to be on... what is it? Fighting in a space with no terrain effects. So if he gets up here, he will be able to get that advantage, in which case he could kill me. Yeah, I think that makes the most sense. Could take most 3 damage here. Yeah. Steel Lance, ugh. Let's move here. No. Let's do this first. Put Arthur in position. Get that damage. Mozu. Stepping in as a hero. Bring myself over here. There you go! That looks much nicer. I mean, I'm gonna kill him anyway, but... yeah. do the Dragonstone. Get rid of that guy.
Evil shall not prevail.
That's much nicer.
I did it!
Okay, we can still do this. So this guy can attack. He can attack the throne space, but he can't actually get there. The problem is that he can go after Felicia if he so desires. Not gonna do anything. Anything significant. I think I'm just gonna put her here. Yeah, let's just put her here. Dagger this chump.
I'll protect you.
Here goes nothing. Ah! Didn't expect that.
Worst time for a crit, I guess. I mean, it wasn't really the worst time for a crit, but it was a pointless time for a crit. Okay. So we're saved from getting the throne seized for another turn. This guy should not be able to kill anyone that I have right now, by the look of it. Especially Felicia now has a dual guard. Arthur's close to getting a dual guard. I'm a dragon, so should be okay in that regard. So we seem to be safe for the moment. These two are okay. Let's switch and give... Oh yeah. Let's give Niles some opportunity.
Oh, that's it?
Why not have an archer kill dragons? And I guess we should move... Yeah. We'll move Odin and Effie over here, so that way whenever they get done destroying the accessory shop, they can make their way over and break themselves upon Effie's armor. I guess I'll move Elise back, so she can help heal. Oh, he didn't even bother to go for anyone. He just went straight for the throne. I'm sorry. Oh, you know what? I shouldn't have done that. I should have let Mozu get some credit. I should have let Mozu get some credit, but that's okay.
All taken care of.
That's okay. Felicia needs love too. She's not even level 10 yet. She needs love. Odin needs love. Elise is almost there. I think she can probably level up to level 10 by healing the folks up here, which will be good. Maybe we can get Mozu in on some action down below. Let's move myself over here. I think she can heal me from there. Yeah, perfect. Perfect! Like I said in a previous episode, I don't really want to waste too much time getting, using up my precious heals, but in this case, I think she's one or two heals away from getting level 10, getting that boost, so I do want that. I do want that. Switch. They're gonna start moving their way up. Let's get another heal.
Justice reigns!
Ah, of course. Two experience away. Of course, she'd be two experience away. So these guys can attack up to this point. This guy... I mean... Even if he crit... I would take 12 damage. I don't want that to happen. Switch! But I can't kill him that way. Yeah, let's do this, because I actually do want... It looks like Effie is still level 9. I want that credit. I want Effie to get level 10. So we're going to switch. We're going to set him up. Iron bow. And we're just going to bring Effie in and finish the job. Oh, and Niles, of course, being one experience point away. That's probably what's going to happen here with Effie as well, I'd imagine. She's going to get up to 99 experience.
What a word got.
98, excuse me. No one's leveling in this invasion. Except Felicia. Felicia already got one level. She's close to another one. But there's a pair up down here. We can take the time to take them out that way. That should be fine. That should be okay. We'll leave the rest of these folks up here. Just build a cool blockade. And finish these guys off. Hopefully. This guy is going to be the problem, but we can handle it. The silver sword, he'll be fine. Restores up to, it's a 20%, yeah, not 20 HP, that would be a little bit ridiculous. Yeah. So I think what we'll do... Yeah, we'll bring in Silas. With his bronze lance. The other guy's a sword too, right? Yeah, they both have swords. Bronze lance, get some damage in.
Let's do this together.
Not gonna take anything from the dual guard. Hey, Niles leveled up. That's the way to do it, apparently. Strength, mat, magic. Really? Okay, whatever. Got more resistance, though. So he's even more of a mage slayer than he was before. And then... Tsubaki's? Tsubaki's do again? Doubles might when wielder skill is higher than the enemy's. Which is not. You know what? I think I'm just gonna leave it like this. 83% chance, we can live with it. Unless we whiff. We're gonna whiff now, aren't we? No, we're not. Excellent.
Well fought.
Seriously? Speed is good, but speed by itself? Eh. Natural cover. What does that do? Unit takes -3 damage when fighting in a space with a terrain effect. Okay. I like that. I like that. We'll have to strategize for that. We'll see what this mercenary has to do. I feel sad for Lilith. She's been sitting there all by herself. Maybe I should just like put her. I should put her fountain like right here. Might have to do that. Just put her right in front of the entrance so that if anyone invades, they have to deal with her directly. I don't want to heal. One damage per person that's not going to be in harm's way. Maybe I should take her, see if I can take her down this way. Give her some heals before the match is over. Ouch, 11.
Oh, please.
11 damage. Oh boy. This could get messy. Oh, and he lunged. So now I'm farther away. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. Can we kill him? 16 damage there, plus 12, 13? No, can't do it. But we can bring him over here. Give him some heals.
I won't forget this.
Finally get Elise her level up to level 10. get her whatever the troubadour. I think it's, is it Demoiselle? I think it's Demoiselle. Yep. So now, wow, she has a huge benefit now. Anyone standing right next to her that's a dude gets -5 damage taken. That's fantastic. I guess we should just go with the Tsubaki, since we're not going to kill him this turn anyway. Might as well reduce the amount of damage he can do. Actually, you know what? I don't care.
I am Fate's accomplice!
Getting close to a dual guard, though. That's it! Oh, he restored his HP, that's right.
We stand together!
He should be dead next round. Especially because he switched places with me. Who do we want to get the experience? Can we set up a situation where Odin can get the kill without him dying? Is 14 HP left? Yeah, we can get that set up. Granted, if we don't, I want to make sure he can survive. What's the chance he has of hitting? 99. Yeah, we'll do that. We'll do that. Alrighty, let's stand way over here. So only 79 now? What happened to the 99? What happened to the 99? Do I have to be right next to him? I do have to be right next to him. Screw it. We're doing it. I'm not sure why I have to be right next to him. Oh, because of the heart seeker or whatever it is. Avoid, hit and avoid -+15 or something like that when I'm right next to someone. Doesn't matter. We'll take it. We'll give Odin all the credit for the final kill.
Much power!
Let him scream obnoxiously. That's it. Effie and Odin. Well, we got a lot of Dragon Vein points for that. GG's all around. That is it for the first invasion. There's no story whatsoever. Probably could have broken that up into two episodes, but whatever. It is what it is. Do we have any support conversations? We probably do. New DLC, which we haven't touched yet. Maybe we'll do that at some point. We'll do chapter 9 maybe next. And then we'll start messing around with some of the DLC because while it doesn't give us any experience, I don't think most of it doesn't give us any experience on the Conquest playthrough. It might be worth it to see the story for certain ones. And also maybe new items that would work. We only have one conversation. Okay, that'll be good. We'll save that for next time. That'll give us plenty of opportunity to just do that one and then go straight into the next battle. So thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed this episode of our Fire Emblem Fates Conquest playthrough. Leave a like if you did. I'm glad we were able to get through that invasion with no deaths whatsoever. We're doing pretty good so far. I was kind of scared for that invasion, but we made it through. So, again, thank you guys for watching. We'll see you next time where we start up a new chapter of the playthrough. So, see you next time.